The company behind Arc Browser is being acquired. Now, Browser Company, who are the creators of Arc and Dia Browser, Dia spelled D-I-A, are being acquired by none other than Atlassian for over $600 million. Yes, you've heard that right, and it's all in cash, apparently. Now, Atlassian have been acquiring a lot of companies recently. For those who don't know, they acquired Loom, and they've also been sort of snapping up big opportunities like sponsoring Williams Formula One Racing and many other things like that. So they're trying to get their word out there, grow their efforts, and this new step makes a lot of sense to what they're trying to build for the future. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Sensama. If you'd like to learn a little bit more about it, you can find the link in the description. It's a more mindful daily planner. I'll check it out below. I've used it for many years and I think it's a great tool. So for those who don't know, Dia, D-I-A, was a AI powered browser and it replaced Arc Browser. Many people loved and used Arc Browser, but they couldn't really get it to work. A few months ago, the application was discontinued. I believe it may even be longer than that, with many people being left upset. But Dia seemed to be the future of the market. And obviously that has paid off fairly well for them. Now, for those who don't know, Atlassian own Jira, Confluence, Trello, and many more applications. So Atlassian believe that with this new browser acquisition, they can enhance the work-focused browser experiences. Now, Arc was well known for tab categorization and organization, and Dia is good at being able to bring those tab organizations and combine it with AI. And they believe that they can take the integration with Dia and combine it into Atlassian tools like Jira, Confluence, and Trello, and many more, making it sort of like a super powerhouse, combining those two tools in one, bringing it together to make it a more work-focused browser application. Now, interestingly enough, in this report, I read that OpenAI and Perplexity both considered acquiring the startup, the browser company, which is very interesting. Perplexity has another application called Comet, which is their version of the AI or agentic browser, which Dia was definitely a competitor of. Now, some other bits of information that you might need to know. Will Dia be going away? Essentially, no. Dia will be available to everyone in public in October. The second bit of news is that this deal isn't officially closed yet. They are reporting to the CEO of Atlassian, but the deal apparently will be closing in December of 2025. And that means that it's past the fiscal Q2 of the company. So an interesting bet by Atlassian. They believe that this is the next experience for work-focused browsers. And to combine that whole experience in one will be definitely an interesting bet. So I hope you enjoyed this news stories. Please do subscribe to Tool Finder if you're interested in finding new tools. You can find Tool Finder below to browse even more. And here's a little bit more about Sensama. So today's video is sponsored by Sensama. Sensama is a powerful, mindful task management software, and it's really popular for those who want to stand back and plan their day more effectively. There's guided planning, reflection upon each of the days that you complete, and great systems in place to help you focus, but also make sure you're not stuffing your calendar and task management with lots and lots of tasks. So check out Sensama below, and thanks for those guys for sponsoring today's video.